I'm Ryan with KE2 Therm. If you would like to access one of KE2 Therm's Ethernet-enabled controllers by directly plugging your laptop into the controller, you will need to set a static IP address on your laptop. And I know it sounds very techy, but it's actually a rather straightforward process, just not something you do every day. This video is going to cover the configuration on Windows 10. Setting a static IP address is certainly possible in other versions, but the process will vary slightly. If you don't assign a static IP address to the controller and computer, it won't be able to talk, and you'll get an error on your browser window when you try to connect. Why? Because the computer has no path set to direct its request to load the controller's webpage. More specifically for KE2 Therms refrigeration controllers, you need to set a static IP address when you're trying to view the controller's real-time operational information, set up the controller for a customer's network, or even bootloading a new firmware version onto an existing installation. The process is relatively simple. First, we need to right-click Start, click on Network Connections, click Ethernet on the left, click Change Adapter Options on the right, right-click the network that your computer is connected to, then go to the properties. Select the Internet Protocol version 4, then click on Properties. This is where we enter our information. Select the Use the Following IP Address button. For our factory assigned 10.10.x controllers, enter the following IP address, 10.10.255.252. Then enter the following subnet mask, 255.255.0.0. Please leave the default gateway and DNS fields blank, that is not required to directly connect to the controller. Click OK. Click Close. Please note that you can perform the same process if the IP address for the controller is changed from the factory 10.10 IP addresses. The same rules apply. IP addresses have to be unique. You cannot use the same IP address of the controller for your static PC assignment will not work. For example, if the controller's address is 192.168.0.50, set your IP to 192.168.0.51. Once you've completed the steps, you can open the web browser and try loading a web page to see if that configuration works. For more information, contact our technical support team.